Very happy morning to all of you kids. Kids, today in this video we are going to revise the chapter Separation of Substances. Okay, so let us start with the revision. Substances normally occurs in two forms in the nature. One is pure form and the other is mixture. In pure form, the substance exists alone and doesn't get mixed with any of the other substance, so it need not to get separated. But if a substance is present in the mixture form, then it needs to be separated. Okay. Now, in the mixture form, there are two types of mixtures, homogeneous and heterogeneous. Homogeneous mixture is the mixture in which its components get completely dissolved in each other, means you can't identify between the components. Okay. But in heterogeneous, the components, they do not get mixed in each other formally, means there exists the proper distinction between the components of the mixture. Okay, now we need separation. Why do we separate? Okay, why do we need separation processes? Because sometimes there are some impurities present which are not good for us, which are harmful for us, or sometimes we need just a pure substance and we don't want any other substance to be present with it. So for that, separation substances are must. Okay, now let us do the separation substances which depends on the state of the substance to be separated. Okay, like the first is solid from solid. If we have a mixture in which we have two types of solids, then how can we separate that? For this kind of mixture, there are five main processes. What are those processes? One is threshing. Okay, then one is winnowing. Then hand picking, then sieving, and then magnetic separation. Okay, now first of all, if we talk about threshing, then what is done in threshing? In threshing, you can say the outer covering or the peels or the sheaf of the grains are separated from the grains by hitting them on a hard ground. Okay, that is threshing. Then what is winnowing? Winnowing is like when you just separate two substances on the basis of their weight. Okay, like lightweight particles, and in this the help of wind or air is taken. Like if the particle is lightweight, then it will be blown away with the wind, and the heavy particles, they will be settled down there only. Okay, so that is winnowing. And in hand picking, what do we do? Like if the particle size is much bigger and you can easily see the impurities, or they are less in the number, then you can just pick them up with your hand and separate it. Then is sieving. In sieving, the particles are separated on the basis of their size. Like the smaller particle, it just cross the sieve, and the bigger particles, it remains in the sieve. Then magnetic separation. Magnetic separation is done in the cases where you have one magnetized and other non-magnetized material. Like if you want to separate iron and sand particles, then iron can be magnetized and sand cannot be. So you can easily separate the particles of iron. Okay, so these are the five separation processes to separate a solid from another solid. Then if you want to separate a solid from a liquid, then there are two cases. One, you have to see whether the solid is soluble or insoluble. If your solid is soluble, okay, like you have sugar in water or salt in water, then there are two processes. One is evaporation and other is condensation. In evaporation, the part or the component of the solution which is able to evaporate, okay, which can be evaporated, that is evaporated, and the other component that remains in the beaker only or in the utensil in which you have taken the mixture. Then condensation mein kya hota hai? Like the vapors which are formed, they are condensed and the another fraction is also calculated. Ki suppose liquid jo hai, jaise aapka water hai, water ke vapors ban gaye, uske baad aapne un vapors ko condense karke collect kar liya. So you can collect the another fraction also, and the substance which cannot be evaporated will remain in the flask or in the container only. Okay, then if you have a solid which is insoluble, then for that we have three processes. Okay, these are basically the two processes, because sedimentation and decantation, these are interlinked. Okay, what is sedimentation? In the sedimentation, the insoluble impurity is allowed to settle down. Okay, and after some time, when the impurity is settled down, then the upper layer of the water that is decanted means poured into the another container. Okay, and what is done in the filtration? In this, the solution is allowed to pass through the filter paper. The impurities or you can say the residue that is remained in the filter, in the filter paper, and the liquid passes on through the filter paper and is collected in the another container. Okay, so what is the name given to the substance which is left in the filter paper? That is residue. And the component which is taken in the another flask, that is known as filtrate. Okay, then we have another mixture like liquid and liquid. If you want to separate a liquid from another liquid, then it depends whether those two liquids got mixed in each other or not. Now, if they are completely soluble in each other, then they are known as miscible liquids and they can be separated with the help of distillation. Okay, what is the basis of distillation? That is the difference in boiling point. That the two liquids to be separated, they will be having the different boiling points. And the another is immiscible liquids like oil and water. Like if the two liquids you are having are not soluble in each other, then you can separate them with the help of separating funnel, whose basis of separation is difference in the density. Okay, so these are all the separation processes depending on solid and solid, like which mixture you are having. Like you are having a solid and solid mixture, or solid and liquid mixture, or liquid and liquid mixture. Okay, so these are the separation processes which we have done in the chapter. Okay, students, I hope that the chapter is revised thoroughly. Thank you. Have a nice day.